Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. First, I want to say thank you to International Conference of Mathematics and Mathematics Education 20 and 21 Committee for the opportunity to join this presentation. And secondly, I would like to introduce myself and my team. I am Nitiasini Mulyati and my team is Tiari Intiati. We are from Combinatorial Mathematics Research Group, Department of Mathematics, Faculty of Mathematics and Natural Sciences, Universitas 11 Maret, Surakarta, Indonesia. On this opportunity, we will present about our paper. The title is Cone-Edged Irregular Reflexive Labeling of Gigantic Kit and Polar Grid Graph. This presentation will be available on International Conference of Mathematics and Mathematics Education 20 and 21 that will be held on 23 to 24 August 20 and 21. For the introduction, we have graph theory. We have a graph that denoted as G. We have set of vertices that denoted as VG. Set of vertices that denoted as EG. And we have graph labeling. The definition about graph labeling is determined by Wallis. A graph labeling is a mapping from the elements of a graph to numbers, usually positive or non-negative integers. Then baca. Explain that there are two kinds of irregular total key labeling. These are edge irregular total key labeling and vertex irregular total key labeling. And Ryan gave a new definition about edge irregular reflexive total key labeling. Edge irregular reflexive total key labeling is labeling on a graph G that carries the edges of graph G into positive integers 1, 2, 3 until key E and vertices of graph G into even non-negative integers 0 to 4 until key V, with K is a maximum value between key E and key V. And Ryan also gave the lemma to define the lower bound of rest G. This is the lemma, lemma 1 for all graph G. Rest G like this, and we have the example of graph G. I'm sorry, we have the example of graph that has been researched before. First is prism graph Dn, wheel graph Wn, pen graph Fn, and basket graph Bn. And second, we have the generalized friendship graphs Fm, n, and corona path and other graph Pn, corona K1, and Pn. Next, we have the corona path and other graph, Pn corona K1 and Pn corona P2. And for this paper, we will discuss about the reflexive edge strength of gigantic kit GKN and polar grid Pm, n graph. The research method of this research is one. We will determine the lower bound of rest GKN and rest Pm, n based on lemma 1. And we will construct the edge irregular reflexive key labeling for gigantic kit and polar grid graph following the lower bound that has been determined. And then we will calculate the edges width such that the width of every edges are different. And finally, we will find the general patterns for rest GKN and rest Pm, n. Then we will have the definition about gigantic kit and polar grid graph. From Albar, gigantic kit graph is a graph that looks like gigantic kit from Indonesia, where the size is bigger than usual and produce a sound when it flounds. Gigantic kit graph that denoted as GKN with n is greater or equals than 2 and 5n vertices has the cardinality of EGKN is equals to 7n minus 2. And the definition about polar grid graph from Galian. Polar grid graph denoted as Pm, n and consists of n copies of Cm number, consists of n copies of Cm numbered from innermost cycle to the outer cycles, Cm1 until Cmn, and m copies of path Pn plus 1 intersected at the center vertex V0 numbered as Pn plus 1, 1 until Pn plus 1, m. Then we will have the characteristic of a gigantic graph. We have to note the set of vertices and set of edges is used for the labeling. And this is the characteristic for polar grid graph. And we will have some notation on gigantic graph. First is VARP, VI, J is for mapping for even non-negative integers to vertices of graph. Second is VARP, VI, J is for mapping positive integers to edges of graph. And the width of it, we denote it as WT, VI, J is the summation of label. I'm sorry, it's the summation of label of edge and the label of vertices on this edge. And we have the sum notation for polar grid graph 2 from the lemma 1 and the characteristic of gigantic graph. We get equation 1, and this is equivalent to equation 2. We will call this as the lower bound of gigantic graph. We also have the theorem 1. For n is greater or equals to 2, rest gkn is equals to scaling of 7n minus 2 divided by 3 if n is not equivalent for 4 or 5 modulo 6, and scaling of 7n minus 2 divided by 3 plus 1 if n is equivalent to 4 or 5 modulo 6. We will prove the lower bound. For n is greater or equals than 2, the lower bound is already proven by equation 2 before. And the proof of the upper bound, we will construct a key labeling VARP on GKN. This is the labeling. And we have the labeling too. So we have the width of edges of the labeling of GKN. From the key labeling VARP above, we can see that every edges are labeled with even non-negative integer. Every vertices are labeled with positive integers, and the edges have different weight each other. So we can conclude that it's an irregular reflexive key labeling on GKN. Since the lower bound has the same value with upper bound, we can prove that the theorem 1 is proven with the k of this labeling is equals to scaling of 7n minus 2 divided by 3 for n is not equivalent to 4 or 5 modulo 6, and k is equals to scaling of 7n minus 2 divided by 3 plus 1 for n is equivalent for 4 or 5 modulo 6. Next, this is the example of edge irregular reflexive key labeling on GK2. Next, from lemma 1 and the characteristic of polar grid graph, for m is equals to 3 and n is greater or equals to 1, we have the equation 3. This is equivalent to equation 4. We also can call this the lower bound of polar grid graph, and we have the theorem 2. For n is equal to 3 and n is greater or equals to 2, rest p m comma n is 4 if n is equals to 1 and 2n if n is greater than 1. Prove the lower bound. For m is equals to 3 and n is equals to 1, since we know that P3, 1 is the same graph as W3. So the lower bound has already proven by Tanna. And for the m is equals to 3 and n is greater than 1, the lower bound has already proven in equation 4 before. Next, for the upper bound, we will construct K labeling for P with K is 4 for N is equals to 1 and K is 2 for N is greater than 1. This is the labeling for polar grid graph for N is equals to 3 and N is greater or equals to 1. And this is the labeling too. And we have the width of edges for the labeling. This is from the key labeling for P above. We can see that every edges are labeled with even a negative integer. Every vertices are labeled with positive integer and the edges have different width each other. So we can conclude that it's an irregular reflexive key labeling on PM, N. For M is equals to 3 and N is greater or equals to 1. And we can conclude that the theorem 2 has been proven. And this is the example of its irregular reflexive key labeling on P3,2. So we have the conclusion from our discussion. Yes, res of GKN for N is greater or equals than 2 is res GKN is equals to scaling of 7N minus 2 divided by 3 if N is not equivalent 4, 4 or 5 modulo 6 and scaling of 7N minus 2 divided by 3 plus 1 if N is equivalent 4, 4 and 4, 4 or 5 modulo 6 and the rest of Pn, N for N is equals to 3 and N is greater or equals to 1 is rest Pm, N is equals to 4 if N is equals to 1 and 2N if N is greater than 1. From this discussion, we have open problem. What is the reflexive edge strength of Pm, N for M is greater or equals than 4 and N is greater or equals than 1? And this is the reference of this paper. This is the last slide of this presentation. Lastly, I would like to say thank you for your attention. I apologize for if I have a mistake. And please don't mind to comment, write comments or your suggestions to our paper so this paper will be much better. And this is the end of this presentation. I would say thank you.